Did you know that at the rate we're going, 3/4 of the U.S. population will be obese by the year 2010? And get this, 80% of our kids are currently overweight, 80%. Well, for a solution to fighting the fat epidemic, Dr. Manny Alvarez returned to his Cuban roots. Take a look.
Dr. Manny Alvarez grew up eating foods from his native country of Cuba. From beans to plantains, Dr. Alvarez says these foods burst with flavor and they're packed with nutrients. In the Hot Latin Diet, Dr. Alvarez unveils 7 powerful foods to include in your everyday life. And he offers exciting, savory, and metabolism-boosting foods to help you live well, feel great, and look fabulous.
Joining us now from New York is Dr. Manny Alvarez. Welcome back to the second 700 Club.
Good morning.
Good to see you.
I missed my plane. That's why I'm here stuck in New York.
Man, I'll forgive you this time, but it's still good to see your shining face.
Thank you.
With all the diets out there, I think it's unique. Why did you turn to the Latin America? A way of healthy eating.
Well, you know, I have reviewed a lot of diet books in the last year and a half, and we keep coming back to a common theme, which is home cooking, balanced meals, a lot of natural products. And if you look at all these fat diets, they in reality don't work. I mean, I was listening to Pat's advice before on the emails, and he's absolutely right. Quick fixes don't work. This has to be, you know, it takes many years to gain weight. It takes a lot of time to lose weight. And one of the healthiest diets out there is the Mediterranean diet, which is, again, natural products and all that. And here in the U.S., we have about 40, 50 million Latinos. I had Latino roots. So I went back and I did a little bit of research on Latino cooking.
Well, you know what's so interesting, Dr. Manny, is the fact that, you know, just traveling all around the world, when you do travel, and especially to different places like Latin America, not only are the people just stunningly gorgeous, but many of them are fit and in shape. But those same people, if they come here to the United States, they start to gain weight. So what is it about the United States that makes us fat?
Well, we exercise less. We get into these quick routines where we don't sit down with our families to have dinner at night. We don't burn a lot of calories because we're driving everywhere. So that if you look at the way people do it back, you know, in other places, they have smaller portions. They sit down for an hour. They eat around people with family and friends, and they tend to be a little bit more active. We kind of lose that when we come to this country.
Well, when you did your study of your culinary roots, which is from Cuba, what are some of the 7 different steps that you were able to realize about your culture that you now want to place in your own book?
Well, one of the things that I wanted to find is there are certain foods that have a double punch, what I call a double punch. They are very nutritious for you. They're sort of balancing calories. In other words, you get good nutrients per your calorie intake. And also they tend to change a little bit your internal metabolism, which ultimately is something that you want to do. I mean, not only do you want to lose weight, you want to get in shape, but you also want to reverse some of the bad processes, if you will, that have developed over time. And so I came up with the superfoods.
Okay, let's talk about the superfoods. What are they? What are some of the 7 superfoods?
All right, let's take an herb, for instance, cilantro, which is like a parsley, okay? It's used in a lot of Latino cooking in the Caribbean basin. This particular herb that you can utilize for many things, you could sort of use it to season meat and things like that. It has a property, not only of vitamins and folic acid and antioxidants, but it also takes a lot of the heavy metals out of your bloodstream. So it's a good detoxifying herbs. The second thing is beans. You know, we Latinos love beans.
Yes.
One particular bean that I think has a lot of good punch to it is garbanzo beans.
Yes.
Now, you can do a lot with it. And the funny thing about garbanzo bean is that it has a lot of fiber. And again, we keep saying that if you want to keep good weight maintenance, you have to eat a lot of fiber during the day.
Gotcha. What are some others?
Peppers, hot peppers, all kinds of hot peppers. Pick your color, the taste, whatever. Habaneros. They're very good for you. They boost your metabolism. They're better than coffee, I got to tell you that.
They have you said they're better than coffee?
Yeah, I was listening to that question also. No coffee. They have something called capsaicin, which is a good inflammatory fighter. So that's very good.
Okay. What about garlic?
What else you got there?
I have garlic and avocado. Avocado is wonderful.
Avocado, yeah. Again, full of good oils, reduces your cholesterol, fabulous for the skin, you know, for ladies. And of course, garlic. I mean, come on, who can live without garlic? It's great anti-inflammatory. It fights bugs and viruses. It boosts your immune system, and it's delicious in any kind of recipe.
You know, whenever I think of garlic, it's kind of like, who can live without it? But the people who have to live with it, but it's good for us, right?
Very good for you.
All right. Well, let's talk about different things. You were talking about the powerful foods, but we have things like, we need to mention the fact that they fight arthritis and heart disease and cancer. Let's touch a little bit more on that point.
Well, you know, the issue with, you know, heart disease is the leading cause of death in America, and it still is for both men and women, and it's a chronic problem. And, of course, this is predicated on two factors. Number one, we're eating a lot of bad fats for you, like the trans fats and things like that. We need to eliminate that. And, again, balanced cooking and eating things like fish, like salmon, olive oil, the avocados, you begin to reverse that fat, and of course you begin to reverse your heart disease, which ultimately is very important for you. The second thing, problem with heart disease, is high blood pressure. Mm-hmm. Now, high blood pressure comes from two factors. People are overweight, and also they take a lot of salt. We love salt in this country. And if you look at the recommendations of salt, no more than 2.5 grams of salt a day should be the max for anybody. So we have to become more inventive on how do we season our food. That's why I mentioned cilantro in my book. But you really get, you know, you need to get inventive in putting other seasoning and get rid of the salt, because hypertension and trans fats are really are the problem with heart disease. Now, when you talk about diabetes, as we mentioned, 33% of American, both men and women and children, are overweight according to some standards. We got to get rid of the obesity problem to get rid of the diabetic problem. We got to bring those glucose levels down. We have to get rid of some of the refined carbohydrates, the fine flours, the cereals. You know, we're going through a little bit of a challenge, economic times today. This is the time more than ever that we have to pay attention to what we're eating, because, you know, one of the key things about sort of feeling good, but also eradicating disease, is prevention. If we focus on our health now, we can be a little more judicial with what happens to our future later on. So, you know, reducing weight, bringing those insulin levels, getting rid of the refined carbs, more complex carbs.
Yes, absolutely, Dr. Manny. And really, really quick, I'm going to jump in and highlight some of the different recipes that we took from your book. And you were talking about the unique ways that we can incorporate some of those seven powerful foods into our foods, right?
That's correct.
And so, for instance, we have cucumber ricotta with coconut, which is right here. And I think that's...
Isn't that beautiful? Oh,
well, that's the fruit salad.
Yeah.
All right, so there's a fruit salad. I'm going to start with that first. But what's so great is cinnamon's on top, and there's something great with cinnamon.
Yeah.
What's good about cinnamon?
The cinnamon, remember, cinnamon is great for diabetics.
Yes.
If you love, if you want to reduce your, you know, if you want to control your sugar, cinnamon is the key.
Gotcha. Okay, right over here, I'm going to see which one they're going to show now, but I think it's spiced up hummus. Ooh, I love hummus. You talk about a wonderful summer dip. Isn't it delicious? And hummus, doesn't it have like garbanzo beans and beans in there?
Exactly. Full of fiber, full of vitamins and nutrients. You could put this, this could become your butter, if you will. You don't need to put butter on anything. You could put hummus, and it's very good for you.
Wonderful.
Especially in the summertime.
Wonderful. Well, Dr. Manny, thank you so much. I'm going to highlight your book real quick before
thank
we run
you.
Out of time. It is called The Hot Latin Diet, the fast track plan to a bombshell body. Well, if you like the recipes for Dr. Manny's summertime snacks, all you have to do is just log on to CBN.com. And remember, these recipes are also in his book, once again, The Hot Latin Diet, and it's available nationwide. Dr. Manny, thank you so much. I appreciate
you. God bless.
Have
thank
a wonderful
you.
Day, you too. Pat, I'm going to throw it back over to you.
Hot peppers and garlic. Fantastic. Capsaicin. Let's go for it. I think Dr. Manny's on to something without question.